Welcome to the next video tutorial, that is Core Java Advanced Object Class Part 5. So in this case, in this program, what we are going to learn? First, let me develop the program, then we will analyze. Class B. In class B, what do we have? We have two members in the class B, int I comma j. Here I'm having one constructor. How to develop the constructor? It is by using the name of the class. In case it is B, this constructor accepting two arguments. First one is int type variable name is I. Second one is int type the variable name is j. So in the body of the constructor, I'm keeping the statements. It is this dot I is equal to I, is dot j is equal to j, is dot I is equal to I, is dot j is equal to j. So what is happening here? Here non-static members, non-static variable, that is I and j. The same I'm trying to initialize here. So this dot I refers to this I. And this dot j refers to this j. And what is the I we are supplying? It is the argument I. And what is the j? It is this argument j in the constructor argument. The next member of class B, it is toString method. We are overriding the toString method of object class. Public string, toString, public string, toString. How we are overriding according to our requirement? So we are returning I plus one string plus j. So we are adding the string to the number, and we are adding string to the number. Finally, it will be string. Whenever it is returning to the caller, in this case toString method, the return value will be string. Now we have these things like totally, how many members we do have, that is 4 members in the class B, int I comma j, and one constructor, and we are initializing that constructor. Then we have overrided the toString method of object class, and we are returning I and j and adding it to the string. Finally, the result will be string while it is returning to the caller. Next, have another class, another public class. So the name of the class, it is M4. The name of the class, it is M4. Now I'm creating an object for class B. In the class M4, I'm creating an object for class B. How I'm creating the object for class B? It is B1 is equal to new B. While calling the constructor, I'm passing two arguments. I'm passing two argument values. I'm passing two values. 10, 20. So B1 is the reference variable, and while we are creating the object for B, we are calling the constructor that is accepting two arguments. In this case, it is this constructor. The constructor which is accepting two arguments, for that constructor, we are calling that constructor by supplying two argument values. We are supplying two argument values, 10, 20. So then I'm having one println system.out.println statement. Now I'm passing B1 reference variable. Observe, reference variable. Now come to the end of the statement, press Ctrl J, and here you can keep another statement that is done. Save this file with the name of the public class, in this case M4. Just press enter. So what is happening here? We know that all the non-static members will get loaded to the memory when we are creating the object for that class. In this case, we are creating an object for class B. While we are creating the object for class B, we are supplying the two argument values, and that calling will be referred to the B class constructor, which is taking two arguments. B class that is accepting two arguments. Okay. Initially, while loading to the memory, I and J will be loading with the default values, default int values, that is 0. I will be loaded with the 0 and J will be loaded with the value 0. After that, we are creating the object. It is we are supplying 10, 20. Okay, we are supplying 10, 20. What happens now? Here we have supplied 10 and here we have supplied 20. So 10 will be initializing to the this dot I. This dot I, it is this one. And 20 we have supplied for j. Okay, that is initializing to that this dot j. Here in this case, this dot j is this j. So now I and j both got new values, that is 10 and 20. Now what I'm calling here, it is b1. I'm just passing the reference, okay, inside the system.out.println. I'm passing the reference variable name, in this case b1. So while we are passing this b1, this reference variable, what it is doing? So internally, it is calling toString method of class b. Internally, it is calling toString method of class b. How it is? How we have overrided toString method in the class b, that is to return the content rather than the object address. Return the content rather than the object address. So here I will be having the value 10 and j will be having the value 20. So 10 colon 20 we will get the output while we are printing this statement 19, while we are executing 19, while the Java executing line number 19, we will be getting the output as 10 colon 20 as the output. After that we will get done. After that we will get done. So come to the command prompt. Here trigger the Java C command. I'm just making use of the previously entered command. So Java C hyphen D double dot slash classes. The name of the class, in my case it is M4. What it is doing? Compile the Java file, that is M4, which is available in the SRC, and come back to previous two folders. There you'll be finding this classes file, classes folder. If this file successfully compiles, you should keep this generated dot class file inside the classes folder. That is what we are telling to the command prompt. Now press enter. If it is syntactically correct, if our program is syntactically correct, so we will be getting the dot class file generated in the classes folder, then we can run that file. Press enter. So Java C command successfully compiled and placed all the Java classes that is available in m4.java file successfully inside the classes folder. Now trigger the Java command. Java hyphen d dot, sorry, in this case we need to give hyphen cp, that is class path, where the class is located, class path. So forward slash classes, the name of the class we are going to run, it is M4. Why we are running M4? Because it is the one that is having the main method. So that is why we are referring M4 to run. So just enter what is the output we are getting. So we are getting 10:20 and done as the output as we analyzed in the program. So this is how we can make use of toString method in our class according to our requirement. If we don't override the toString method of object class inside our class, the default implementation will be executed. The default implementation, it is returning the object address rather than the content. So that is the importance of overriding toString method in our class. According to the requirement, we are developing or overriding the toString method in our class to return the content rather than the object address. Okay, this is it for this video tutorial. I hope we have learned something from this video tutorial. In this example, we will analyze the next program in the next video tutorial. Thank you.